Filmed at Oscars in Palm Springs, it's the Mark and Tony Show, starring Mark Lantaro and Tony Pomponio. Today's special guests, soulful singer Gennine Francis and showman and magician Jeff Hobson. Here they are, Mark and Tony.
What a crop! I can always bank on him saying, what a crop. Say it one more time, please, because that is a big audience.
Hold on one second. What a crowd!
Everybody, if you didn't realize, Rodney Dangerfield is in the house. My better half, my sidekick, or I'm his sidekick, I should say, Mr. Tony Pomponio.
You gotta make sure you get that.
I gotta make sure I said that right. You're gonna get a real sidekick. Oh, mercy. So, hey, listen, we haven't seen one another for the better part of a week.
I know,
so.
This has been terrible.
Any questions, any good things you want
to
bring up?
Well, I'd like to talk about where you've been all weekend. I missed you.
Well, I have to tell you, I went on a little excursion with my better half, Miss Carol Latham, my daughter, Nicole, and her sidekick, her boyfriend, Patrick, or Pat as he likes to be called. We went up to wine country. I decided my daughter's never been to wine country. She wanted a taste on a lot of different vintages of different wines. She had a great time. Let me tell you something. She didn't want to board her plane today to go back home.
Matter of fact,
I just heard her just now, Carol, wherever you're at out there, she just texted saying that she's back in Chicago.
That's
so
awesome.
So all is good. So in my absence.
In wine country, I couldn't board my plane.
What was that?
I heard a voice somewhere out there.
What was that?
Could that be Miss Laura Hagen? Or as we like to say, the queen out there in the darkness, everybody.
So,
what have you been doing in my absence?
Well, while you were gallivanting around in wine country.
Can I tell you?
I stayed home.
Yeah,
and I observed Memorial Day.
Very good.
Right? Let's face it, folks. Memorial Day, what does it stand for?
Everybody, an applause for that. Come on.
Let's give it up for our veterans, those that gave up their lives to make our lives better, right? God bless
exactly.
The USA.
We're all here because of the USA and what has transpired through the years and time.
That's
so
right.
We thank our...
Before we run out of time, I got to say one other thing.
Okay, please do.
I want to give an update on Sonny Velocci.
Yes, right? We must. Yes.
Yeah, we have to do this. So Sonny's doing well. We spoke to him today. He wanted to be here tonight with us, but the wife said no.
Is that him peering through the curtain back there?
I don't know. You never know.
You never know. I don't trust him. But go ahead.
Anyway,
go ahead.
So he's doing great.
Yes, he is. And we know it.
He's doing great. He's recovering extremely well.
Yes.
He's following his doctor's orders. He's going to be back with us real soon. So how about him, Sonny?
And in Sonny's absence, my better half again, Miss Carol Latham is taking over the helm. And of course, Christy's here. And of course, Laura Hagen somewhere in there in the lurch of the dark.
Right back here.
And of course, Tony and Steve here, the camera guru of everything. Steve, just wave. There you go.
And of course, let's not forget our makeup artist.
Our makeup, yes, right.
But we have a special guest. After the break, we have a gentleman here by the name of Jeff Hobson, which I believe Laura brought up. So everybody stay tuned. We're going to be right back. Tony.
Well, I got one more thing to say. Voila.
Oh, that's right. That's right. We have a special thing to say.
Oscars,
right now.
Cabaret. Saturday night, 7 p.m. Come on down.
I understand it's a great show. I'm playing Vanna White here for this. Yes.
Don't miss it. It's awesome.
Yes.
Okay.
So, all right. So that being said, you ready?
Yep.
Ready? We'll be right back.
Kimball's unique boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look. Large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention the Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
The saying goes, a picture is worth a thousand words. At GRA's Visions, we create photography that speaks volumes and comes across loud and clear. Specializing in beautiful portraiture, we also offer photographic excellence from corporate to candid, in banquets or backyards, and from formal to fun. GRA's Visions is the only real answer to your photographic needs. So if you want it to look great, call 760-218-1938.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Mark and Tony this afternoon or early evening. As I said, going into the break, we have a very special guest this evening.
Right.
Tony and I have had the opportunity with the girls to see him in action. Mr. Jeff Hobson is the proprietor working at the Marvin's Magical Theater.
Absolutely.
So everybody, a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Jeff Hobson.
There he is.
Oh. There he is. Jeff, how are you?
Ta-da! Nice to see you.
Nice to be seen.
Good. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Can I take that seat? Because I want this to be the Mark, Jeff, and Tony show. So if you sit over there.
So Tony is finally getting his way. He's kind of moving me out
exactly.
Here.
Okay. Exactly. Spread the red sea here.
I'm loving this.
I'm going to sit down like this. Nice. Thank you very much. This is great. Good. Wonderful.
I love the coat. It looks
fantastic. Thank you. You just touched me. I don't want you to touch me.
Oh.
Thank you.
It's already. My hand is starting to disappear.
I'm from Detroit. You know, don't touch me.
Detroit. Yeah. Another Detroit. There
you go. Don't touch people from Detroit.
That's right.
Otherwise, you might lose an arm.
There you go.
Well, wait a minute. That's normally up to Chicago people to say you lose an arm.
Chicago guys.
Chicago? I'm from Chicago.
You guys all know nothing.
Yes.
Better pizzas.
Well, thank you for that.
It's deep dish. They just throw a bunch of stuff in there and they think it's good.
All right. Anyway, all right. I'll get a referee here.
All right. So you are originally from Detroit.
I am originally from Detroit, and then I moved out to Las Vegas, and had a long career out there.
Give the audience a little bit of the background from Detroit to Las Vegas. How does this all come about?
Well, you know, I was like the kid on the block there in Detroit doing lots of shows for many years, and then in my late 20s, all of a sudden I got a call from a producer in Las Vegas, said, hey, we've been keeping an eye on you. Would you want to come out and replace a guy that's leaving this in a show called Spellbound, a concert of illusion at Harrah's right on the Strip?
Oh, wow.
And I said, okay. Yeah, sure. Well, after that, next thing you know, that month ended up for 26 years. You know,
Like
you're doing one show and then it lasts for 4 years, and then you know you do another show and another show.
It was a great.
And so the whole time I spent mostly on the Strip. So I did a lot of shows down there.
What did you think of Vegas?
It's hot, but it's not. You know, but here actually it's hotter.
So you came here to cool off, right?
It was beautiful. I raised three kids there, and
congratulations.
Thank you. And so now they're all on their own, and now I'm here. Doing Marvin's Magic Theater for the past 3 years.
And that's fantastic. Tony and I and the girls have had the opportunity of going to see you and everybody over there. And I have to say, if you haven't had a chance to go see his show and all of his performers over there, please make a point of doing it because it is fantastic. Tony and I were there with Carol and Franny and, of course, my daughter, Nicole. And we had a fantastic time.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah,
thank you.
Of fun.
It's a special place. It's the type of place that I've designed the theater. It's 130 seats. Nice
stadium
rig.
Seating.
Seating. Yep. You can see everywhere you want, and it's especially made for magic and comedy and fun and variety arts. And so we've been going for 3 years, less about a year and a half for the pandemic.
Yeah.
You know, and I was really nervous, to be honest. You know, I don't know about you guys or entertainers out there, but when you don't work or in front of anybody for like a year and a half, I felt really self-conscious. You get in front of a group and you think, oh my gosh, you look in the mirror before you go on, oh my gosh, I got older, I got gray, I gained weight, and then I look
don't talk about the gray hair. I knew that was going to come up. No,
but listen. I look at the audiences and I think, what a coincidence. Yeah. You know, so
hey,
it's
wait
fine.
A minute.
So we're all here.
So listen, tell us about the McCallum Theater. You understand that you performed at the
McCallum
Theater?
Yeah, matter of fact, I was 7 years on tour with a show called The Illusionist Live from Broadway. And it's the same sort of thing. Somebody saw us and said, hey, let's start this. And we started the opening night was at the Sydney Opera House, right? Sydney Opera House. And everyone thought that was going to be it's going to last a month, 2 months. That was 7 years, right?
Well, and when you make a stop.
Yeah, I know.
I
do. Yeah, my wife's not pleased with it, but yeah, it's one of those things. So we traveled around the world for 7 years and two seasons on Broadway, and it was quite a shock, because I never even knew as a magician you would be on Broadway at all. And next thing you know, they say, we're going to perform on Broadway, and some people ask, they said, well, what's it like going to be on Broadway? I said, I don't know. I never thought this was on my bucket list, And we did two seasons, and it was wonderful. It was just great to work every single state, all 50 states. I mean, you bet.
What an experience.
We did lots of shows. And then I decided to quit and come here on the seventh anniversary, 7 years to the day, and the Sydney Opera House, our second visit, and I was at the Sydney Opera House again, and I got the chance to do this in the Coachella Valley, and I said, you know what? I think 7 years is a good run, right?
I think it's a good run.
Yeah, it's
a fantastic run. So I got to ask you this.
Yeah.
I know the answer to this, but I want you to explain to the audience. Obviously, your name's not Marvin. No. How'd you come up with the name Marvin?
Well, if anyone hung around the Valley for long enough, there was a magician named Marvin Roy, and he was known as Mr. Electric. You can go on to YouTube and see all of his videos, and he toured 30 years on the European cabaret circuit, wow. Crisscrossing all over. He did was twice on The Tonight Show, twice on The Ed Sullivan Show, 7 years touring with Liberace, and he spent the last 20 years of his life here at PGA West in La Quinta, working, just being a great guy. And he was also D-Day plus one and a double Purple Heart recipient. So he's a war hero and a great guy.
There's a person with a lot of history. That's right.
And really. So he was a great magician, and we decided, what are we going to call this place? And the founder, Gary Butler, said, hey, you know what? I think we should call it Marvin's. And I went, of course. And so Marvin was there every Sunday afternoon watching the shows until he passed away.
Yeah. Oh. No, I have to tell you, your shows, again, not to go full circle back, your shows are fantastic.
Thank you.
Please, I don't mean to echo this, but I am, again, if you haven't had the chance, make a point of going to see him and his show.
Well, yeah, please.
Yeah,
and,
I would.
And also, we're open. We decided that a lot of locals stay here for the summer.
Right.
Not all of them, but about half
and
at least.
It's growing.
It's growing.
It is growing.
And I decided to stay open for June and July and do shows on the weekends at Marvin's Magic Theater. So this is our first weekend that we're going to be open during the summer.
Congratulations for that, too.
Thank you very much.
Very good. Yeah. So check it out. Yes. So, you know, it's really cool because when you first walk in, there's like a little waiting area. And you're kind of looking at stuff, and then you go into another section where there's a bar. We can order a drink, and you have these special glasses, non-pouring type, not spilling glasses.
Adult sippy cups. We call
them. And then we got Johnny Meza in the foyer playing for entertainment, and then you work your way into the theater. It's really cool. I mean, I
it's a whole experience. It's a whole evening thing you do.
But see, and that is the key. It's a specific. And it's electric, no pun intended. Nah, it's a fantastic evening. If you're not entertained, then you just don't know what entertainment is all about.
Thank you. I see you're sitting in the middle here.
Did you push me off to the
side? Well, you know what it is, really, is I wanted to show, because, you know, when you watch magic, you have to be watching from all angles. And from one angle, so here we go. It's a law among magicians, you have to do at least one card trick in a program. So just let's get this over with. What do you say?
I'm going to move forward because I want to make sure I can see.
No problem. It's a brand new pack of playing cards, sanitized wrapper for your protection.
Yes.
Oh, wow, that was close.
Moving right along.
All right, take a look. We've got a few jokers. Don't need them because these guys are here.
We have the new comedian. Wait a minute.
Now you're stepping on my time. We only got 10 minutes. Come on over here. Hold on. I can see what you're talking about.
He talks too much.
Just teasing. Oh, look, it's a queen. I don't know. You guess. Who's that? We got a senior citizen quality pack of playing cards. Look at that. Big pips. Gladys Knight could not be here. Let's see if I can. Oh. I know. Oh, yeah. I know. That's called the Russian shuffle. One card Russian right after another. Oop. And a couple trying to get out of the country. Go. You're free. Yeah, I know. The Jewish shuffle. Passover. I'm Jewish. And a born-again Christian, just in case. You never know. You know. Let's find. Why don't we do this? Why don't you, if you could, pick a card. Okay. And your name, Tony, you do it. You could spell it backwards. Why not?
Yeah.
Why not? Okay. And so you got that.
What do you
got? Yeah,
and
this.
Please take and sign your name right across the face of the card, real big. Sorry, it's chained down. I lost three last week, and I don't trust you. No. On the face. There you go. Yeah. Then don't pull. I'm not sure what it's connected to. So just keep going. There you go. As soon as you're done, I'll take it back. That's how I got it. Do appreciate it. How nice. My Bank of America is very happy. Place the card in my fingertips with the face outward so I cannot see the face, please. Thank you. Can everyone see a signature? Everyone?
Yep.
No? Right over there. Do you see it? Good.
Sonny, can you see it on the phone, Sonny?
Now, I do not know what this card is.
Really?
Look at the guy. Oh, he's good, isn't he? He's good. Stop scratching. You'll heal faster if you just leave it alone. His card, his signature. Most people say if you're really good, why don't you let someone shuffle the cards? That's what Mark is here for. I'm going to let Mark shuffle the cards. I love that name, Mark. It's like a dog with a hair lip. Mark.
Yes.
Go ahead. Take it and shuffle the card. Shuffle. Now look, he's shuffling. Look at it. Shuffle. Oh my.
Oh,
and it's okay. It's okay. I don't play the full. I don't play the full deck. You're okay, good man.
There it is.
All right.
You can't even shuffle cards.
It's okay. I will place the cards in my mouth. Locate Tony's card with a signature with my tongue in my mouth, folded three times. Do you believe this?
Sure.
Well,
sure.
Then you do it. Oh. Right now it is. Watch it.
Well, is this his real card?
No.
No. Is this it?
No.
No. Is this it?
No.
No. What's it in the middle? Lock, lock.
No.
Let's just go that it was.
We're not done yet.
I got it.
Hold on, you can get it.
Hey, hold on, three times, I'm not gonna touch it. Could you take it out of my mouth? No, just teasing. I don't know where your hands have been. Here I have one.
Okay.
Slimy card.
Yeah. Here, get this sleeve too.
One card that you picked.
There you go.
It's folded once, it's folded twice, it's folded three times. Could it be, would it be, I don't believe it myself. Yes,
oh, yeah.
That's
it. Is.
That's it, that's it, that's it. It.
Hi, I'm Mark Lantera.
And I'm Tony Pomponio. Tune in every Thursday at 1 o'clock on Spectrum Fox 11 or Channel 33 on the Dish and DirecTV Network.
Music, comedy, interesting interviews every week on The Mark and Tony Show. Be there!
Kimball's Unique Boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look. Large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention The Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
Gieri's Visions, visuals from concept to completion, specializing in distinctive logos, identities, and branding. From business cards to banners to billboards, Gieri's Visions is your best graphic solution.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Gennine Francis.
Spanish Harlem. She's living a life just like a movie star. Oh, Maria, Maria. She fell in love with East LA. To the sound of the guitar played by Carlos Santana. Pickpocket on the corner. See the rich is getting richer, the poor is getting poorer. Some little Maria on the corner, thinking of ways to make it better. In the mailbox there's an eviction letter. Somebody says see you later. Ora vengo mama chola mama chola. Ora vengo mama chola. Ora vengo mama chola mama chola. Ora Maria Maria. Reminds me of a West Side Story. Growing up in Spanish Harlem. She's living a life just like a movie star. Oh, Maria, Maria. She fell in love with East LA. Yes. To the sound of the guitar. Carlos Santana. Santa Bella, Dolores, the streets are getting hotter. There's no water to put out the fire. Mi canto la esperanza, the Mira Maria on the corner, thinking of ways to make it better. Then I looked up in the sky, hoping to see paradise. Ora vengo, mama chola, mama chola. Ora vengo, mama chola. Ora vengo, mama chola, mama chola. Ora vengo, east. Ora vengo, mama chola, mama chola. Ora vengo, south side. Ora vengo, mama chola. girl, you know you're his lover. When the wind blows, he can't forgive you. When we're together, even when we're far apart, still feels like we're together. Maria, Maria, she reminds me of a West Side Story. Growing up in Spanish Harlem, she's living a life just like a movie star. Oh, Maria, she fell in love with East LA to the sound of the guitar played by
please do the honors of introducing this beautiful woman to my right.
Boy, I'll tell you what, that was a fantastic song, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
That was awesome. What about that, folks? Isn't that great?
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gennine Francis. Wow. Let's start at the very beginning. Where were you born and raised?
Born and raised in Compton, California. I'm number six of eight kids. And gosh, I graduated from Compton High School, just me and my siblings, and we all sing. Ended up out here in the desert singing on my honeymoon, go figure.
So how long has that been? How long have you been here?
I started at Blame It On Midnight in yes.
Right, wow, down the street. Really?
Yes, right down the street.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Worked there for 10 years, and not long after I started there, I ended up at all the resorts and things. So I've been full-time out here for almost 21 years.
Wow, congratulations, everybody.
What a beautiful heck of a run so far. What a beautiful voice as well.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about what's going on in Compton. You were telling me a little earlier.
Oh, wow. Yes. I am going to be on a reality show. Trifecta Entertainment has just cast me to play one of the queens of Compton. So.
How cool is that?
I know. It's like, oh, my gosh. So I'll be playing alongside of seven other women that I don't know.
The Whitney Houston tribute. I'm very interested in that because, first of all, you have that look, that dynamic, and obviously that sound. So let the audience know a little bit about that background, please.
Well, here in the desert, they kind of insisted on it. When I started working out here, I would often, you know, have folks say, oh my God, you remind me so much of Whitney.
Yes.
Can you sing a Whitney song? And so I had like three that I felt like I can do okay. So over the 20 years, I was sticking with those three songs. And then they kept saying, you should do, you know, a Whitney look-alike, sound-alike. And I was like so uninterested in that, you know, for several reasons. So I said no, clearly I said no for all the way up until 2013, right? The year after she passed.
Right.
And then they just would not leave me alone with it. And they was like, she's gone now. You have to do this tribute. So now I do a tribute to her.
Okay.
It's called The Essence of Whitney, and I'm proud to announce that I'm going to be presented with the tribute at the Agua Caliente Rancho Mirage.
Wow.
Yes.
And when is this gonna take place?
It's gonna be July 22nd. And it's so exciting because when I do this tribute, I work with celebrity bands.
Okay.
But this is the first time that we're gonna have multiple Whitney musicians on stage with us.
I'll be darned.
Yeah, so it's gonna be
so cool. So yeah, please. So with that said, now obviously you're singing more than just three songs of Whitney, I'm guessing.
You have a whole concert.
Look at doing Whitney Houston is not easy.
Okay? No.
And there's a lot of people that shy away from it.
And that was me. That was my main reason for saying no, because I felt like with Whitney, she's got these huge shoes. Now I really have big feet, but but my feet are not big enough for her shoes.
Well, I'm telling you, you're doing a fantastic job.
Amazing.
And would
incredible.
You do Tony and I the honor, along with the audience, would you please sing us another song?
Absolutely. Come on.
Please. Everybody.
Take me some melody. You're on my mind constantly. And it's good to know your mind all the time. Hey, Mr. Melody, you mean the whole world to me. And without you, I would have no song. Oh, Mr. Melody, you got me humming to your grave to be. The more I hear it, the more I like it. You really been here for me, Mr. Melody. The sweetest things to me. Please won't you stay here for all time. You are my melody. You're just as sweet as you can be. And it's good to know you're mine all the time. Oh, Mr. Melody, you love who it makes you sing. I like loving you, you like loving me. Please don't ever change, Mr. Melody.
And we had two wonderful guests this evening. We have a new platform that I want Tony to bring up that we are so gracious that Dan Gore of Oscars put together for all of us. Tony, would you please let the audience
know?
Yeah,
we got a new website. It's themarkandtonyshow.com. So go on. Yeah, how about that? Hey, so go on, sign up, follow us on themarkandtony.com website, and you'll know everything that's going on, and they'll always have episodes as well that you can watch.
Oh, Tony, please. One more shout out for this.
Oscars Cabaret, Saturday nights, here at Oscars, in the showroom, 7 p.m. Come on down, join the fun.
So it's your next time. Tony, are you ready?
Yes, here we go.
We'll see you next week.